All right, guys, before I start this video, I'm going to tell you it was a learning experience for me, and I hope I got enough of it for y'all to learn what I learned in the process. Here we go. Okay. This customer said it was tripping a breaker, and the breaker was tripped. Let's see if it shows a short to ground. Contactor's kind of burnt. I'm gonna put power to it real quick. And let's see what happens. Alright, so it's clearly not a direct short. Alright, we're going to do amps. Already overloaded that one. Let that equalize just a little bit. Stop hissing. That compressor is loud. Go to amps. Come on. Compressor sounds really loud. Make sure we don't have power. Nothing. Nothing. That right there is supposed to be an 80. I'm pretty sure I don't have an 80. It's reading 80. That's loose. Oh, old Klimatuf compressor. 2007 R22 compressor, 25 RLA, 148 LRA. Let's check. Some other things. Let's check this right here. Make sure this is turned off. It's starting okay, it just sounds loud. microfarads. We're going to take the top off and ohm out the compressor. First, I'm going to ohm the ground. Nothing on that one. Oh, sorry. I got 42 mega ohms. Seven mega ohms. Thirty mega ohms. Let me go get my maker. Don't let me forget my clients down there. Easier to get in here than it is to lean over. I think it was this one there. And there's a ground right here. Keep my fingers away. That's saying good. All right. Good. All of those are reading good. So let's keep ohming out. And see if we find anything else. All right, we got, hold on a sec. Coming to start, I got 0.56, that's kind of low. Coming to run, 0.4. Also kind of low. So it ohms out good. Alright, at this point, I need to see it run for a little while. So we're going to go in and turn it on and see how it does. Holy smokes. I would say, yeah, it made a noise. Whew. Dang. That kind of startled me. I'm checking to see if at any time do we lose 24 volts. I'm not seeing it. They're getting a new contactor. All right, so let's get this thing changed. I do have it turned off at the thermostat. Let's see what happens. I'm making a bad connection somewhere. All right, so I think I should tell you what I ended up doing. This right here. That leads to a temperature probe on the hot gas discharge. And it was shorting. So I bypassed it until we can get another one. Okay guys, what I was having trouble explaining and showing at the time, it was getting dark, my camera was giving me troubles. That hot gas line has a temperature sensor that looks like a defrost thermostat. It's like it opens when the temperature gets too hot, and it's in line from the yellow that comes out of the board, goes through a pressure switch, and then through that temperature sensor to the contactor. So that temperature sensor was cutting it out when it shouldn't have. And right now it's bypassed, and replacing the contactor was burnt from it chattering like that, so it was not a waste of a part. The thermistor or temperature sensor should be on the way soon. I hope you enjoyed that video, and like and subscribe if you haven't already. I'll catch y'all in the next one.